The Gold Coast water war is threatening to erupt again amid predictions the City Council will renege on plans to regain control of its assets. Residents rallied for months to bring prices down. Now it looks like those protests may have been in vain.
Breaking up is hard to do, especially when there are tens of millions of dollars at stake. Council split from water company AllConnex was shaping up to be a messy divorce, but there could end up being a last-minute reconciliation with angry ratepayers caught in the middle.
The victory is still there, it's just these people don't want to take it. Let's face it, all they want to do is grab the profits.
A report on how much the Gold Coast will have to pay to go it alone on water supply is due on Thursday. Already the Mayor's predicting a huge bill.
$50 to $60 million, that's virtually doubling, well, not doubling their rates, but it's putting a 25% impost on top of their rates to get it back.
We've told everyone we want our water back. But at what cost? Is it going to cost more? I mean, it's going to upset people even more.
Council would also have to cover substantial losses felt by the other owners of AllConnex, Redlands and Logan councils. And ratepayers will ultimately have to bear that cost.
It's an open chequebook. That could be anything.
But some argue the short-term pain would mean long-term gain.
Unless we take the water business back, those water charges will continue to rise.
Coast residents fought long and hard just to get the authorities to even think about disconnecting AllConnex. Now, when it comes to the crunch, they're not about to let them cut and run.
Come March next year, they face the people. A lot of those councillors in there will not be around if they don't make the right decision.
On the Gold Coast, Jessica Ross, 10 News.